So let's engage seamlessly. You can guys, and if you guys see this.
Yes, everyone, you can see it clearly.
Okay. Okay, thank you. So we have around 8 tabs, I think, yeah. Around here 8 tabs. Starting from replacing backlog to test driven teaching. I hope almost all the speakers join. If any of the speakers not join, we'll skip the talk and we'll go on to the next talk. And if the speakers join late, you will have the talk at the end of the talk, end of the session. Okay, so let's start with the first talk, replacing MATLAB in signal, speech, image and video processing by Dr. R. Chandil Kumar. Sir, are you available?
Yeah, it's audible, but unmute me.
Chandil Kumar.
Yeah. Unmute me.
Hello.
Sir, audible, unmute me. Whether my voice is audible?
Yeah, your voice is audible, sir. You can try sharing mostly.
Yeah, sir. Shall I share my PPT?
Yes, sir. Sure. Before that, I wanted to ask, anyone like to volunteer taking meeting minutes? If anyone wants to volunteer, you can raise hand.
Okay.
So, first come, first sir.
Whether the screen set to you is visible to you?
Sir, give me a moment. Give me 2 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
Kushal Chand like to write a meeting minutes. You can take informal notes of what is happening today, and then after the meeting, you can send the item to the meetings. Am I right? I can't go over. Okay. Thank you, Kushal Chand.
Okay, sir, can I try sharing the screen?
So we are not able to see
your
screen.
Sir, shall I share my screen?
Yes.
Whether the PPT is visible to you?
No.
Whether the PPT is visible to you, sir?
No. Yeah, now it is visible. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Shall I start?
Yes, please.
Yeah, okay. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Chennai Python Group Meetup, August Meetup, 22nd Saturday today. Happy Ganesh Chaturthi to all the group members. Here I am going to give you a lightning talk related to replacing MATLAB in signal, speech, image and video processing. And this is Dr. R. Chandil Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Institute of Road and Transport Technology, Erode. Right? What are the Python libraries to be installed for signal processing? Purchasing MATLAB as a single user license, it will cost around 3 or 4 lakhs for signal processing itself. If you want to purchase a MATLAB library, signal toolbox or block sheet for image and video processing, speech processing, and all, it will cost more than 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs.
Excuse me, sir.
Okay.
Your voice is breaking.
Okay, Sir, whether the voice is clear to you?
Yeah, now it is clear, but when you started, it was breaking.
Okay.
Do you have headphone mic? Are you using headphone mic or laptop mic?
Laptop mic.
Okay.
Whether it is clearly audible now?
Yeah, now it is audible. Yeah.
Okay. When you are going to purchase MATLAB for signal processing, speech processing, image processing and video processing, it will cost around 3 to 4 lakhs for a single use of license. Python is open source, its libraries are free of cost. We can use Python for signal processing, image processing and audio processing, speech processing and music signal processing also. So here I am going to give you an overview, in brief. What are the libraries usable? What are the Python libraries can be used for signal processing, image processing, video processing, and speech processing? The Python libraries suitable for signal processing: Matplotlib, NumPy, SciPy. What are the possible algorithms can be implemented? Up to me, I know some 17 to 20 applications can be implemented in the Python libraries. Continuous discrete sine waveform plots, changing stem plot, linear convolution algorithm, autocorrelation, correlation algorithms, Fourier transform, fast Fourier transform algorithm, plotting mantis spectrum, phase spectrum, discrete Fourier transform, writing own functions for signal processing algorithms, fast spectrum estimation, filter design, finite impulse response filter, infinite impulse response filter, different variety of filters we can design. These are the references. I have taken all those materials from this. You can download my programs from these websites if you want to practice signal processing using Python libraries, image and video processing and speech processing, right? This one is how to plot a sine waveform, how to plot a discrete sine waveform. Okay.
Do you have any headphone?
Yeah, I have headphone. Say right. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, now the voice is clear. Voice is clear. Now voice is clear. Audible and audio. Oh. Now whether it is clear now. Yeah, okay. Oh, this one is the continuous sine waveform, how to plot discrete sine waveform and stem plot. And implementation of linear convolution algorithm, implementation of cross correlation algorithm, correlation algorithms, and implementation of Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform algorithm, and how to plot mantis spectrum, amplitude spectrum, and how to write own functions for signal processing using Python, power spectrum estimation. This one is very important signal processing application, and this one is the power spectrum estimation plot and generating filter design, windowing techniques for filter design, and FIR filter, how to design a digital FIR filter, DSP filter, how to design IR filter, how to process image and video processing. These are the Python libraries necessary for the image and video processing: Matplotlib, NumPy, SciPy, Below, OpenCV. Okay, you can refer more information from these websites. How to install Python 3.7, NumPy, SciPy, Matplotlib, and OpenCV. You can do a simple image read and write. You can change color of the image. You can convert gray image to color image. Image resizing, interpolation, histogram plot. Cropping a portion of an image, shape of an image, you can change grayscale conversion, image transform, image filtering, image details, and changing image file format, sample outputs. These are the examples for still image processing. using Matplotlib and Pillow Python libraries. Using OpenCV, you can do still image processing. So OpenCV provides more advanced still image processing applications. You can do like simple image read and write, you can resize, you can change the, you can convert color image into grayscale image, you can do horizontal cascading, vertical cascading, you can display more image, more than one image in a single image window, you can do image transform, you can do image resizing, image interpolation, image denoising, filtering, all those applications using OpenCV. You can do do your video processing using OpenCV, capture a color video from your own camera and convert into gray video and gray binary video, capture a video, capture a color video and get its frame width and height, set the user specific frame width and height, play a recorded video, capture a converting color video to gray video, converting color video to gray and gray to binary video, video blurring, filtering, high pass filtering, low pass filtering, video resize and interpolation followed by video blurring. You can do face recognition, you can do fingerprint recognition, you can do iris recognition, edge detection, image segmentation, video masking, histogram equalization, histogram plot, video image transform, video motion detection, etc., etc. And you can do speech, music and audio processing using Python libraries. These are the sample Python libraries used for audio processing. Built-in models available with Python 3.7, and these are the Python libraries, platform independent, whether these are common to Windows, Linux or Android mobile phone. These are PyTorch 3, available in Ubuntu Linux, available in Windows, common to Windows, Linux, Android platform, and platform dependent given in the beneath. GStreamer, PyL as audio, and audio shortcut. These are the useful links for audio processing, audio, speech and music processing. You can refer these websites for more information for audio, speech and music information. That's all about today's lightning talk. Any questions? Chat box. Shall I use speaker? No? Yeah. I come to chat box. Raghuraj sir, whether my voice is audible? Muralidharan sir, the mother voice is audible? Yeah, yeah. Anyone want to chat? Or anyone have doubts, put questions in a chat box or switch on your mic or put your questions in a chat box. So since this one is a lightning talk, I have only 10 minutes time. So within 10 minutes time, maximum I explore Python libraries related to signal processing, speech processing and image and video processing. I am going to share this with Python group after this my meeting. This PPT not only contains the results of signal processing, video processing and sound processing, also I have given the links, my Python codes posted in GitHub and video tutorials in YouTube. All those links are available in my PPT. After this meeting I am going to share this PPT with Chennai Python group. Okay, any questions? A general tip, lightning talk, fast talk, okay. Not lightning talk, not
tick talk. Actually, lightning talk is lightning talk, doesn't mean it is a fast talk.
Okay. Within 10 minutes, I have to give all those informations, all those libraries related to signal processing, speech processing, image and video processing. What I have?
Hello, I'm Arul. Yes, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Inspire people into presentation and see how we can impact others with that. And once they are interested in the topic, they can go and read about it further. So this is how you would probably organize a work with that.
Yeah, okay, any other comments? Any other comments?
Can I say something? Can I say something? Am I audible?
Yeah, audible.
This is such a very interesting subject. The first time I'm hearing about all this. And unfortunately, we have not much details. I'm very thankful if doctor can share more information on this subject. Seems very interesting. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I am also consider the Vijay Kumar, Mr. Vijay Kumar, what a hint, a lightning talk, naughty quote, fast talk. So within 10 minutes, even if it is a small information, I got to confirm it in, I got to deliver it in interesting, somewhat interesting like that. Any others? Any other comments? So, sir, don't hesitate to post comments. So that I can rectify my faults in a next talk or next lightning talk like that. So post your comments even though in chat. If you are not. Okay, this is my email ID. I'm using to communicate with the Chennai Python group, rsenthil.optical@gmail.com. This one is my WhatsApp number, 9940826. Okay. Thank you, sir.